Hello people and welcome! In this video we will see how to create an intro with Adobe Premiere Pro CC. Please leave feedbacks to improve mistakes in pronunciation. This is the intro video that we want to make. This is a very simple but cool video, a nice example to start up making intros with this software. Of course, you will be able to make much better intros, but you will need more practice. Our goal is to teach you the basics of how to make it as a first step. If you like this intro, you can download it in the video description. First of all, after getting a general idea in mind, we can collect the video loops needed. These are called video loop backgrounds and are videos right made to offer the basis to make an intro. You can find them simply searching on Google, or you can visit some links in the video description. Make sure to use video loops that are under Creative Commons licenses or you infringe copyrights. These licenses lets you use freely the loops for your projects. In our case, we choose a tunnel loop and an abstract one. The first one leads on the second part of the intro, dedicated to the text. But the video loops downloaded may be not the ones you expect, so we need to edit them too. Open Premiere Pro and create a new project file. Don't mind about presets and go to OK. Drag all the video loops in the project window and a new sequence then. Don't mind about presets again. The first thing to notice is that the tunnel is going too slow. To speed it up, we need to use the time remapping option and increase its percentage. To get help at applying effects, watch the related video in this show. If this is not enough, we can trim. Press R from your keyboard to activate the rate stretch tool and reduce the length of the video until the speed is OK. There is now another problem to solve. The video loop is now too short. All we can do is to repeat it. We won't have problems with this, since it is a video loop, so a clip that can be repeated over and over. So simply copy and paste it as many times as you like. However, to modify it better in the future, it is better to render this clip in full. Since we don't need audio here up to now, simply select all the clips, right-click and go to unlink. Then you can delete audio without problems and then render. Don't mind about the render settings and all, you will adjust them later. If no other video loop needs to be edited, we can start making our intro. Create a new sequence and import your video loops in. Make sure to use a correct aspect ratio of 1280 by 720 or 1920 by 1080 to upload in HD in YouTube. Choose Settings on top and choose Custom in Editing Mode, and then type the resolution. Make sure to put an aspect ratio of 1.0. Once done, just go to OK. Drag the rendered video on your timeline. Its resolution may be too much small. So simply select the clip from the timeline and double-click on the preview to scale it enough to cover the black bars. Next step is to connect the clips and add some effects. For example, we can make this tunnel from normal gray to a strange blue and then a flash transition can lead to the second part of the intro. Since we want the tunnel to change during time, we must use a video transition between two clips, the gray tunnel and such modified. So let's create a copy of the tunnel clip and modify it, for example with the dreams effect available by default. Then we can add the transition between the two, for example using the film dissolve effect. To get help in video transitions, watch the related video in this show. Then we can connect the tunnel clip with the abstract one, with a deep to white transition, after scaling all to cover the black bars. If you aren't able to put a double side transition, simply reduce a little both clips. Then use effect controls to adjust the transition the way you like. Then, in the end of the video, you can add some blur that increases in time. Add a Gaussian blur in the abstract clip, for example. Drag it from the effects window and then use the keyframes in the effect controls to change it in time. The graphic phase is now done. Mind that while adding text or other effects, you may come back changing clips or their effects or transitions. Now we can add the text. An intro video is made to present your channel through your username and, if you want, with a subtitle, for example a motto or subscribe. While it is easy to choose the text content, it is hard to place it and choose its font well. This strongly depends on the style, the video loops used, and even the music you are going to add. In this case, we choose to make the text move, becoming bigger and bigger and more blurry at the same time. But this is not the only possible solution. Use your own inspiration. It may be tough the first times, but the more intros you will make, the better this will be. Then we can choose to add some audio effects or a single soundtrack. As for the video loops, you can download these under Creative Commons licenses to use them freely for your intros without problems. Have a look in the sites listed in the video description. In our case, the soundtrack fits perfect, without using any extra effect or audio transition. In other cases, you may need to adapt audio too, as you did for the video loops. Practice! When the intro is done, you just need to render it. The adjustments done are ready at the right aspect ratio to avoid black bars. Just apply 1280 by 720 or 1920 by 1080 pixels in render settings, and you will render in HD in YouTube. This is all. Download the project in the video description to see closer how this was made. Thanks for watching.